सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस और रिमाइंड अगेन द ग्रीडी मेथड एंड देन वी विल गो टू द ऑप्टिमल मर्ज पैटर्न. ओके, सो इन द ग्रीडी मेथड्स यू आर गिवन एन इनपुट्स एंड यू नीड टू फाइंड ए सबसेट कॉल्ड ए फिजिबल सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द एन इनपुट सब्जेक्ट टू सम कंस्ट्रेंट्स. ओके, एंड सेटिस्फाइंग ए गिवन ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन. Like in fractional knapsack, what was your objective function? To maximize the benefit. And provided the constraint was that you need to take the items with the total weight according to the knapsack capacity. Okay. So you cannot take items whose total weight is greater than the knapsack capacity. So this was the constraint in the fractional knapsack, and if the objective function is maximize or minimize, the feasible solution is optimal solution. So there might be many feasible solutions, but one of them will be optimal, and greedy approach will always give you the locally optimal method. Okay, the immediate benefit, maximum benefit, or the immediate optimal solution. Okay, not the long term or according to the pre-computed values or comparing the other patterns or subsets. Okay, now the algorithm for greedy is you need to choose an input from the input set based on some criteria. If no more input exists, okay. So what we have done in fractional knapsack, that we have taken each item which increases the load up to the knapsack capacity. Okay, less than or equal to the knapsack capacity. Okay, and if an item weight is greater than the remaining knapsack capacity, then we take its fractional part. Okay, and if some input is not yields to feasible solution, then we should discard it. Okay, so we always include the input in the solution vector and update the objective function and then go to step one. Now again, the one of the problem of greedy approach is optimal merge pattern. And what is this? That you are given some files with some number of elements, and these files are to be merged. Okay, so if you are given n files, then what is the minimum time needed to merge all n files? And as you know that merging two files with n and m elements respectively takes capital O asymptotic notation, big O n plus m time. Okay, so this is the time required to merge two files, and here's the example that you are given some files f1 f2 f3 f4 and f5 with the number of elements 20 30 10 5 and 30 respectively. Okay, so f2 and f5 has the maximum number of element and f4 has the minimum number of element, which is 5. Now if you do it in the sequence given or by any random merging, then you cannot get the optimal solution, because here one of the merging is that you have merged in the input sequence. Okay, so f1 and f2 merging will take time 20 plus 30, that is equal to 50. Okay, and again the merged file is now in m1, and you need to merge it with the file f3. So m1 and f3 will give you the 60 time units, 50 plus 10. Okay, approximately this will be total time. Okay, similarly you will merge the m2, the resultant file, of F1, F2, and F3 merging with the file number F4, and it will give you the 65 time, and again the complete merge file M3 into the last file F5, which will take time 65 plus 30, that is 95. Are you getting my point? So total time taken is 270. Okay, but this is the time which is taken in into the input sequence if the merging is done according to the input sequence. Now we need to merge these files by choosing the greedy method, and using the greedy method you will see that it will take the optimal time in each pass. Okay, and what greedy method says that you must merge first two smallest number of element files, then this merge file or resultant file must be merged with the third smallest number of element file, and then this resultant should be merged with the fourth smallest number of element file. Okay, and so on. So each time you find out the smallest element number file to be taken into the consideration first to merge them. Okay, so this is the method that we will take F4 as the first file, and then we will take F3 as the second file. Okay, so we have sorted these files in the increasing order of number of elements. Okay, so first F4 and F3 are merged, then they will get 15 elements in it, and the total time will be 15 approximately, big O 15. Are you getting my point? So like this, if we merge the files by considering smallest to largest number of element file, then we find out here that the merging time can be minimized. Okay, so you can see here that merging of first two file will take time 15, merging of next two files, the first resultant M1 with the next smallest number of file, that is F1. Okay, getting my point? So F1 has total elements 20, and it is taken at the number 3. Okay, so when we merge them, then we will get 15 plus 20, that is 35. Okay, now what we will do, we will take the next two smallest number of files. Okay, and what are these next? Not the resultant one of in this pass, because this has total number of elements 35. Okay, so you must choose first two smallest, that is file number F2 and F5. Okay, so file number F2 and F5 both have number of element 30, and they are merged. Okay, and then the resultant of last pass is merged with the resultant of current pass. Okay, so 35 plus 60 is equal to 95. Okay, so the merging time of all files can be calculated like this, that each time we merge two files, it gave you the resultant number of elements in a merge file, and also it gives you the O, big O m plus n time. That means the number of elements in the merge file is equivalent to the time required to merge those files, okay, in big O notation. Okay, so total time is big O 15 plus big O 35 plus big O 60 plus big O 95 is equal to 205. So you can see here that when we applied greedy approach, then it took only 205 time units, big O 205. But when we did it without greedy approach and did it by first come first serve method or the input sequence, then it took 270 unit time. That means big O 270. So big O 205 is smaller than big O 270. Okay, so this is how the optimal merge pattern of files can be found. Now the problem is how we can do this. Okay, so we can do this by making a binary tree each time and inserting a new node into the binary tree each time whenever we merge two files. Okay, so initially all the files can be kept as the binary tree, and they will have left child, wait, and right child parameters in it. In every node will have left child, wait means number of elements in the file, and right child, which denote the right child of the node. Okay, so here you must correct one thing here, that left child and right child are initially taken null. Okay, because they because the tree has no left child and right child, it has the single root. Okay, so initially all the files are kept into the single node binary tree. Okay, and one more representation of it is that you denote by the left child with the single node and right child also with the single node and root also. Okay, so these binary trees have only weights initially. Now we will merge the minimum weight binary trees first and so on. Okay, so each time we will select the first two smallest weight binary trees and merge them. Okay, so like this we will merge them, and the resultant tree will have the node having the total weight of the merge binary trees. Okay, so weight of the new node of the tree has the total weight of the merge binary trees. Okay, so this is how we merge them. Okay, first we merge 5 and 10 with the 15, then we merge 15 and 20 because these are the two smallest weight binary trees. So we merge 15 and 20, okay, into the binary tree with the node weight 35, okay, and one left child and one right child. Okay, now at this step you will not merge the binary tree with the weight 35 and the binary tree with the weight 30. Instead you will take the two least cost binary trees here. Okay, and these are 30 and 30. So now 30 and 30 will be merged together to form a new binary tree. Okay, so here you can find out that there are two subtrees with the root 35 and with the root 60. Now these two subtrees are merged into a single binary tree. So 35 plus 60 is equal to 95 is the weight of this binary tree, and it will have two child, okay, with the weight 35 and 60. Okay, and when you compute the weight of internal nodes, will give you the optimal merge pattern cost. Okay, so 15 plus 35 plus 60 plus 95, these are the internal nodes. We will not calculate the weight of external nodes. These are the 5, 10, 20, 30, 30 or the terminal node. We will always compute the weight of the internal nodes. So this is how we make a binary tree, okay, least cost weight root in each binary tree, okay. So this algorithm actually finds a least L, that means it finds the least L function finds a tree in given list L whose root has the smallest weight. And there is a function tree ln in which we will input the total list, okay, which is the global list L, and the number of nodes, which is N. And we will traverse into the loop for I is equal to 1 to n minus 1. And why it is the loop for I is equal to 1 to n minus 1? Why it is so? Because for the n element, you need to merge n minus files only. N minus 1 files only. Okay. So it will run from 1 to n minus 1. Are you getting my point? So if you are doing it into the C or C++, then it will go from I is equal to 0 to n minus 2. And if you are doing it by some other indices method, then or you can see how it is done in mathematics, where we take indices from I is equal to 1 to n minus 1. Okay, so from the programming perspective, you will start it from I is equal to 0 to n minus 2. Okay, now this is how it is done, that we will create a node pointed by tfast, okay, and then we will create its left child with the first smallest file to be merged, okay, and then the right child t, which will have the return value of least L, that means the second smallest from the global list given, okay, and then weight t, that means the new node weight will be the weight of left child plus weight of right child. And we will insert this node into the current binary tree at any instance. Okay. So every time we will insert this node by insert function. Okay. Which inserts new tree with root t in L. Okay. And after doing all the iterations of for loop, this algorithm, optimal merge pattern, will return the least L, which means it will return the tree, binary tree or merge binary tree having the total list, total elements which are given in the list L. Okay. So this is how we do this. And when some hint I am giving you, then when you will make the program for it, you will have to use the structures, and you will have three parameters in the structure. For the left child, you must have a pointer, and for the right child, you must have a pointer, and for the weight, you must have some integer value. Okay, so three parameters each node will have, and get node T will create an instance of that structure each time. Are you getting my point? So this is how we do this algorithm. Okay, and analysis we will do in the next class. And now you are required to do some example which I will give you, and ask some queries related to it. Okay, so this is how optimal merge pattern is done by using the greedy approach. Okay, stay home, stay safe, and keep learning. Now I am open for the queries and doubts.